Understanding Snowstorm, a guide for English learners. Hello, everyone. Welcome back to our channel where we make English learning easy and fun. Today, we're diving into a fascinating aspect of the English language, understanding the term snowstorm. This is a word you might hear often, especially if you're interested in weather or planning to visit or live in a region where snow is common. So, let's unravel the mystery behind this term together. A snowstorm refers to a weather condition characterized by heavy snowfall and strong winds. It's more intense than just a light snowfall, and it can significantly impact visibility and travel. When we talk about a snowstorm, we're describing a situation where a lot of snow is falling from the sky, often accompanied by gusty winds. In some regions, snowstorms are common during the winter months. Understanding a snowstorm involves knowing its two main components, snow and wind. Snow, this is frozen precipitation in the form of ice crystals. When these crystals stick together, they form snowflakes, which are what you see falling during a snowstorm. Wind, this is the movement of air, often quite strong during a snowstorm. The wind can cause the snow to blow around, reducing visibility and creating what is sometimes called a whiteout condition. Snowstorms can have a significant impact on daily life. They can disrupt travel. Airports may close, and roads can become dangerous due to icy conditions. Affect power supply. Heavy snow can bring down power lines, leading to outages. Close schools and businesses. Due to safety concerns, many places may shut down during a severe snowstorm. In English-speaking cultures, snowstorms often appear in literature and conversation as symbols of challenge or beauty. You might hear phrases like "battling a snowstorm" to describe facing a difficult situation, or "as pure as snow" to describe something beautiful and untouched. We hope this video has helped you understand what a snowstorm is and how it's viewed and talked about in English. Remember, language is not just about words, it's also about the culture and experiences they represent. Stay warm and safe, and see you in our next video.